Hi, it's me. And today I'm talking about how I have a friend. And this friend, he went on a date with this girl, and the girl said to him, "You know, in Russia, we give you, a guy shows you he likes you by spending some money on you every week. Get out the guard and you buy me some clothes." And he goes, "I don't like that. I don't like that. I don't like that. Oh no, no, no." And he's like freaking out. And I'm thinking, what's wrong with him? Like, here someone is giving you a hint and telling you, you know, how you're gonna get in advance. I mean, what could be better? And he's rioting, you know? Like, what could be better than someone giving you a hint? Usually girls, there are no hints with girls. Like, they're, like, very mysterious, and you have to compliment her. But in a not-so-sort-of compliment way, like, not too complimentary. Like, you can tell her, oh, you look good, but you can't tell her, oh, your boobs look good in that shirt. You just say, oh, well, it's a beautiful shirt. And, you know, you can't ask her, you know, about how much it cost or where you got it, because that's so offensive. You know, so you have to think of exactly the right way that you have to compliment that shirt. And, you know, you have to ask her questions, but they can't be too nosy, the questions. Like, you've got to be like, oh, well, you know, where are you from? Where did you grow up? But you can't exactly ask what street you grew up in. You just be like, well, vaguely, where are you from? Like, the basic longitude, latitude points, where are you from? And, you know, you can't ask her too much about her job. You can't even ask about a job, because what if she doesn't have a job? And then what's she going to say? You know, and you have to, you know, not ask too much about her friends, because then what if it means you're interested in her friends romantically if you ask too much about her friends? But you can't not ask about her friends at all, because then that might mean that you're, like, not interested in her as a human being and you don't care about her. Oh, no. You know, so you've got to figure out, like, a right balance and what to say. And, you know, you maybe you can open the door and maybe you can't open the door, you know, because maybe you're a gentleman. Maybe you're not a gentleman, you know. So you got to, like, what are you going to do? Like, open the door halfway and then hope she makes it through, or, like, kind of put your hand out for the door to indicate you want to open the door, but see if she protests. I mean, like, it's, like, so hard to figure things out. And, you know, it's so hard to figure out what exactly to say and what to do. And, you know, maybe you should pay and maybe you shouldn't pay. Because if you do pay, then it's implying that she has to sleep with you. But if you don't pay, then it implies that you're a cheap bastard. So it's like, what do? You know, what do you really do? And here she is giving him a hint and telling him what he can do to make her happy. And he's like, oh. And it's like, he's like, well, I want girls to like me. I want them to like me. And he's like, I want them to like me. And his friend goes to him, I don't even like you, and I've known you 30 years. How's someone gonna like you in a week? They get like many different guys. And it's, like, true, you know, that, like, he pretty much maximizes how to not get people to like him between, like, having, you know, a nightmare child, having cheating tendencies, and wanting people to do freaky things. He has all the reasons for someone not to like him, unless they love tennis or music. Anyway, that's me.